welcome back to this special report, Pain and Suffering, the Opioid Story. To give some perspective on how big of an issue the opioid epidemic is, we want to give you some numbers tonight. The CDC says more than 106,000 people died from drug overdoses in the U.S. in 2021. Now, it's important to note the state of Alabama has not finalized overdose death stats for 2020 or 2021 yet. But to give you an idea, more than 15,000 people were admitted to the ER for drug overdoses in 2021, and EMS responses to probable drug overdoses have been going up by more than 1,000 each year the past few years, with more than 10,400 in 2021. But it's so important to remember these are not just numbers. They're real people, moms, dads, sons, daughters, friends, neighbors, coworkers. Addiction does not discriminate. At just 23 years old, Dylan Stogner lost his life to an overdose. News 19's Kayla Smith sat down with Dylan's family as they shared his story and the hope they have for others who are supporting loved ones in similar situations.
You know, the sadness over losing Dylan is hard to carry. It just changed us and it's broken our family's heart. But I want to also say that there's hope in recovery.
Last year, Dylan Stogner lost a years-long battle with substance abuse.
Dylan was a beautiful person, and he was a good person, but it wasn't always easy. You know, we had some really, really hard, tough times.
His path toward recovery wasn't straight. Good times came with the bad, and he visited rehab more than once.
You know, it used to break my heart when Dylan would say, you know, I just want to be normal, like, you know, all my friends. And I wish he could have loved himself as much as everyone around him loved him.
Dylan's mother, Jennifer, says he always went out of his way to love and support others. His father, Pat, remembers his courage, taking on many challenges in life. His personality was magnetic.
His spirit and his sense of humor and his talent.
I have beautiful memories of him making us laugh. His music, he loved the guitar.
I wouldn't keep it all inside. I let you know how much I love you every day.
He loved encouraging people through his music, and he loved life, but he struggled, and I think that's, I just want people to be realistic that we don't have to be perfect. We're not perfect.
They have a message for those seeking recovery and their families.
We can't be afraid to talk about it. If we suspect that our children are, you know, struggling, we need to find a support group and find them support that they need. And, you know, they don't always just outgrow it.
I think there's still a huge stigma with male pride and ego. And I want the fathers and brothers and uncles, the men, to know that this getting support is the difference.
You are not alone, and help is available.
Those people that we have found community with, you know, they encourage us to try to find purpose in our pain.
Have patience.
Do the work together. Stay strong. Dylan spent a lot of good time in recovery. And he has a lot of beautiful friends that are, you know, still in recovery and finding purpose in their life.
There's not one road to recovery.
Even though we lost the battle with Dylan, I know some really beautiful, strong people that are living in recovery. And that's what we have to focus on. There is hope. You know, there is hope for healing, and remember that they're good people trying to get better, and we're all good people trying to get better. It's just hard. Addiction is hard.
She says her faith has carried her through this journey and continues to carry her today. Reporting in Huntsville, Kayla Smith, News 19.